Hello and welcome back. This is of course Wanado with another Stein World tutorial. It's been almost 2 years since my first 10 tips for Stein World beginners, but we are back with 10 more tips and we are ready to go. So let's get right into this list. Number one on the list definitely wasn't around 2 years ago when my first video came out. That's because the login rewards was added in one of the most recent updates. And this lets you get a daily login reward varying from scrolls that do various things, boosting your experience, very useful for beginners, summoning parties so you don't have to walk across the whole map, crates and resources, all the way down to an extra deposit box in the bank, which you might not have got to in Wilden back yet, but it's very useful, so definitely be using these. And if you have a Stein account, you can get a whole bunch of extra rewards. If you want to see how to unlock these daily logins, do check out my video on the update, but you need to head down into Farshore, and you go into this house here where the armorsmith and weaponsmith are, and you can find more details there. Number two on my list is related to professions. Once again, you'll see that my inventory is full of various different materials. Now, I've got the inventory space to do it. You might have less space and not have all the pockets yet, but it definitely fills up, especially once you start processing these resources as well. And my tip here is that many of the professions, so armorsmith, as you start, you need copper and you need hide. But you'll see that once we get up to these resources, copper is mining, and you need an agate for the Cry of Blight. You need another gem, Tiger's Eye, for the Shoulders of Valiance. For the Visage of Heroes, you need Malachite, and so on. So you only need gems to do all the way up to level 10. So that means if you wanted to do processing armorsmith, you can do mining and get your gems and armorsmith together and get them both to level 10 before moving on to do, say, herbalism and enchanter, which these ones only need enchanting materials along with your base ingredients. So if you group your professions together, get them up to level 10 and then focus on some other ones, that's a good way to save on your inventory space and give you a bit more flexibility in how you play. Number three on the list is a piece of advice that I haven't actually actioned myself, but is on my list of things to do, and that is to join a guild. There are probably hundreds of guilds at this point, and you can also search up ones. Ooh. So if I go search and I can go, I don't know, Hashelstein, I know, is a guild. So there we go, and that's one's fully leveled up. Very cool. I think this is the first ever created in-game. Very neat. But you can also make your own guild. But the reason I am advising that you join a guild is that this is a very cooperative game, especially if you want to do the high-level dungeons like Winterhold, Bitterberg Keep, and Bitterberg Ruin, which you'll get to once you get up to level 30. And it is useful to have guild members to help you out, lend you a hand, they can give you resources and just progress through the game itself. There's lots of benefits to being in a guild, so do find one that suits and get stuck in. Number four on the list is a stat which you might not have too much knowledge about, and that is the threat level. So my threat is 100%. There are items that can make this go higher or lower. And threat level basically determines which person the monsters are going to attack. So if we have Mord Kaiser here that I'm going to use a hand on, and he attacks, because he's attacked them, he's now got a higher threat level and they are chasing him, even though I could literally stand right on top of them. And if I attack him now, then he turns to me, but he sticks on me because I've got a higher threat until he moves back. So there's various things you can do to increase your threat, and he heals me, which is very nice of him. If you have a same threat as someone, if one person is standing still and the other person is moving around or even just spinning, then they will become the target for the monsters in the map. So it's very useful. You can use it to your advantage if you have one person who's a tank and one person who's a healer. But good to bear in mind, if you've got a high level of threat, then you're probably gonna get targeted. Number five on my list is to join the Stein World Discord. I'm sure there's links to it on the Stein World website. It has got a whole bunch of useful information, announcements for when the game is being updated, rules information, general chat if you wanna just talk about Stein World in general, but also there is a party finder if you want to do dungeons, as well as tutorial questions. So if you have any doubts or any questions, you can get them clarified here. I've used this a lot. Lots of useful information. So here, I didn't actually know this, that for trees and such to respawn, it takes 5 minutes, plus or minus 45 seconds, I guess, which is very handy, as well as lots of other information. So do make use of this. I have on multiple occasions, and it's helped me out in my Stein World questing a whole bunch. Number six on my list of top 10 tips is to use the Player's Marketplace CASDAQ, Carmack's Association of Stein Dealers Assisting Quests. And I get this acronym wrong. I quite often say CADSAC, not CASDAQ. So if I get that wrong later on in the video, apologies. But this is a marketplace run by Carmack, I should say Carmack, not Carmack. and it has almost every single item in the game, how much they've got in stock, how much you can buy it for, and how much you can sell it. They buy at this price as well, and you get discounts and extra money for selling at different levels of stock. There's different sellers in the game and they get various commission as well. So if you want to become a seller, then maybe build up some trust with the marketplace. But it is very useful for buying resources if you need them, if you want to avoid that grind, or if there's stuff you just simply can't get. So do consider having a look at this marketplace. And they also have a Discord, which I'm sure you can get a link to if you ask, in the Stein World Discord, which I referenced earlier. It's very useful seeing selling to the market, buying from the market, announcements and stock prices. All the information you need will be here. Tip number 7 is very similar to tip number 5, and that is to make the most of the Stein World Wiki. It has loads of information on all the parts of the game, but most importantly and most useful is the quests page. So I don't know if you've seen people in chat ask, where is so-and-so? Maybe Marius, Aeneas, and even if you're an expert on the game, there are so many NPCs, it's so hard to remember all of their names, and let alone where they are. So if you control F and you put in the name of the person you are looking for, then you can scroll through very quickly and find. So if we were doing Meadow Grove Farm quest, and we got to kill Jakra, and we had it from Marius Aeneas, say we needed to find out where he was, we can click through and it takes you through to the NPC page where you can do the same thing and scroll down to find him, and it tells you where he's found. Stands in Meadow Grove Farm, which then if you click through and you don't know where he is on the map, my website's being a bit slow to load, but you can click through and find him on the map as well. So it's very helpful, cuts out a lot of time, and just control F is your friend here, and you'll be able to track down people in no time. Number 8 on the list, you know the Cadsac marketplace that I referenced 2 points earlier in this video? Well, it's time to put it to good use. If you're needing cash, everything is worth gold, and by everything I mean even trash. So I'm collecting grass and old buckets, which are worth 1 gold each in the game, but I can sell them to the marketplace. I believe grass is 100 gold each, so 8,600 gold, nice and easy there, and buckets are 70 each. And every piece of trash has a value that the Cadsac has assigned based on how much people want it. And if you collect it up and sell, it's very easy money. So even pile of bones, little tooth, all of these things are worth money. The only restriction really is how much inventory space you want to save up getting the trash. But if you do collect it and sell it, it can be a very, very good money maker. 9th on my list is the ability that monsters have, and it is something to definitely bear in mind. So I'm sure this probably has happened to you if you played the game already, but it's good to know what their abilities are. If you've been hurt by a monster and you are running away from them, getting out of their reach, they do have the ability to web you like such. Now I can't move and I've got the snare effect. And if you don't know this is coming or you're not prepared for it, it can spell the death. They also have the ability to slow you in space, and then they use a special little magic effect on them and they can run super fast to catch you up, which can also be very annoying. So the magic effect can happen out in the wild, the webbing can happen out in the wild, but it also happens in dungeons where it's possibly more dangerous with the monsters that can deal a lot more damage in wave dungeons, as well as the dungeons that run kind of more like a classic dungeon crawler. So something definitely to be aware of and bear in mind, and make sure that you have enough health to survive these and some sort of ranged weapon to take them out at a distance if you do get stuck in place. And rounding off our list today for 10 extra tips for Stein World beginners, we have not getting too hung up on dungeons. So you might be doing Cycle and Chamber level 10, and you might be grinding that out, trying to get as far as you can to get the best, the legendary items. But all of these items will only be level 10. And if you've watched my first video with tips, you'll know that as you level up past level 10, your item's hit chance will decrease all the way down to something along the lines of 20%. And when this happens, no matter how legendary the item, if you can't hit with it, it's not much good. So don't get too hung up on getting through the dungeons. That will come once you get to the level 30 dungeons, and it'll be time to start grinding out the rare drops that you need to craft the best gear in the game. But Cyclone Chamber, Abandoned Cemetery, even Mulan Garrison, all of these up to level 30, not including level 30, but all the ones below, don't worry too much about trying to get the very best items. If you get a good drop, then fantastic. But it won't be useful for very long if you're leveling past that level of that region. So those are my 10 additional top 10 tips for beginners in the Stein World. Do comment below which you found most useful, or if I missed anything out. that's going to do it for today. If you're interested, do check out my first video if you haven't seen already. There's a lot of useful information there, as well as the rest of my tutorials on professions, wave dungeons, specific professions, and my Let's Play is always a good source of information, as well as a lot of fun to watch me level up and hopefully become one of the best in Stein World. But thank you very much for watching. If you haven't joined this video, please do consider liking and subscribing. It helps me out a whole ton. But until next time, goodbye.